Hi and welcome to this week's Tech Talk. Today we're going to be looking at the static bypass, which forms part of all online dual conversion UPS systems, whether they be three-phase UPS or single-phase UPS. Now on the board here I've got a basic line diagram of an online dual conversion UPS system. Now the online dual conversion UPS system operates simply by taking the power from the main supply on this side, converting that power from AC to DC via the rectifier, then we re-invert that power from DC back to AC again via the inverter in order to supply power to our critical load. Now the static bypass, as the name infers, effectively bypasses the entire UPS system here, from the input side here to the output side over here. Now depending on the configuration of the UPS, whether it be a single input UPS or a dual input UPS system, will determine whether or not the bypass supply here will either take the power from the same source as the rectifier, in the case of a single input UPS, or if it's a dual input UPS or a dual fed UPS, then effectively there are two supplies coming into the UPS system here, and therefore the bypass supply here is on its own dedicated source, and the rectifier is also on its own dedicated source, and hence the term dual input. Now in terms of resilience, the dual input option is the preferred method. Now the purpose of the actual static bypass itself is to transfer the load seamlessly, that is with no break, from the output of the inverter here onto the bypass line here, whether it be automatically or manually, should the needs arise. Now the reasons that can cause the UPS system to automatically transfer the load from the inverter onto the bypass line and vice versa, such things as if the inverter or the rectifier here were to fail, or there was a problem with the controlling architecture within the UPS system, which meant that the output voltage waveform from our UPS here was having a problem or was beginning to collapse, then the UPS system can seamlessly transfer the load onto the static bypass line and hold it there until either the matter is resolved, or if the matter can't be resolved, it will maintain it until further action is to be taken by the intervening service engineer. Another reason why it would transfer to bypass should be if we have a fault or an issue on the downstream side of the UPS, such as an overload or a short circuit, then again the UPS system can transfer the load cleanly onto the static bypass line here in order for the fault to be cleared, and then it can return back online again once that fault is cleared. Now sometimes as well it could be activated manually by such as a service engineer. Now if a service engineer is maintaining the UPS system, he will transfer the load onto the static bypass switch here in order so that you can transfer onto the main wraparound bypass and therefore provide a complete seamless transfer. And then he will then return this back via the static switch when he's putting the UPS back into circuit once he's completed his maintenance. And therefore the static switch allows the user or a service engineer to seamlessly transfer the load onto the bypass and vice versa should they need to. Now the bypass itself is made up of two primary components. You have the back feed protection and you have the main static switch. The back feed protection there is basically there to prevent the UPS system from back feeding power through the bypass line here when there's no main supply here, and therefore if there's no main supply here and the UPS is supplying the connected load via from the batteries, then effectively we don't want any power trying to flow back through the static bypass switch there, and therefore the back feed protection device prevents this. Now the back feed protection device is typically made up either a contactor which will physically open and therefore we can't pass any current back, or it will be via a current device so that if we measure any current flowing in the bypass line when we are on battery operation, then the UPS can take the appropriate action. Now the static bypass switch itself is so called because it's effectively no moving parts, it's static and it's not like a mechanical switch. It basically comprises of two components referred to as thyristors. Now thyristors over many, many years have proven themselves to be a highly reliable component and hence a perfect application or a perfect component for this kind of application. Now in this case we have two thyristors in parallel with one another but facing in opposite directions. Now the purpose of that is because the upper thyristor here effectively conducts the positive half of the AC voltage waveform, whereas the lower thyristor here conducts the lower half of the AC voltage waveform, and therefore when they're combined and both switched on, they effectively act like a switch, or in this case a static switch, by passing the voltage from the inputs here to the output side over here. Now one of the main things that must happen within any UPS system to allow a zero break transfer is that the output voltage waveform from our inverter here must always be in synchronisation with the supply voltage waveform that's coming in via our bypass switch. Now if that's not in sync, unfortunately the UPS can never make a seamless transfer, and some UPSs will simply not transfer to bypass, or put in a designed dedicated break within the supply in order to make sure that no problems occur and no damage to the load occurs. In this case, the UPS system itself will always try to maintain that the inverter output, again on this side, remains synchronized. And basically, by being synchronized, that will allow the UPS system to instantaneously transfer the load from the inverter onto the bypass line and vice versa. Now, if you don't know what I mean by synchronization or in phase, then what we can do now, we can take a look at an oscilloscope and I can physically show you what the waveforms look like when they're in phase or out of phase. Okay, so if we take a look at the oscilloscope, the waveform that we've got across the top here is the waveform that is supplying the bypass line. The waveform along the bottom is the waveform that is being produced by the inverter. Now, if I move those two waveforms over one another, you can see clearly that they're practically identical and hence in phase with one another. Now, if I instruct the UPS system to disable the synchronization like so, you will see that the two waveforms now stray apart. Now, under these conditions, the input and output are no longer synchronized and hence the bypass line would be unable to transfer instantaneously. However, if I now force the UPS system to resynchronize again, like so, you can see that the UPS system resynchronizes the inverter output and hence an instantaneous transfer to static bypass can take place. Well, I hope you enjoyed that tech talk. If you have a question that you would like us to answer here at Riello, then please drop us an email to techtalk@riello-ups.co.uk. Thank you.